guys, this is reset your brain, reprogram your brain. I'm gonna do a quick tutorial on the JKD footwork. This is like, I don't know if you know, but like I was saying previously, I feel like JKD has a lot to do with boxing, and a lot of the footwork that I noticed, from my understanding, has to do with a lot of boxing footwork, okay? As well as fencing, of course. But this is something that I'm gonna teach you, because I believe you could incorporate this into your JKD training. Also, you could incorporate it into any kind of fighting style or any workout you do in general. So what we're gonna do is that this is something that I learned when I was training. Like I said before, I used to train for a little while, and this took me maybe like 3 months of constant drilling of doing footwork. Before I even learned how to throw a punch, I was just drilling footwork. So the way it works is like this. Okay, so I want to make sure you have your weight, but when you standing, what you're gonna be doing is gonna be stepping, because it actually only takes like only a little inch or little millimeters to be able to avoid a punch and be able to give a punch. So it only takes fractions of a second, it takes fractions of movements, and only a little bit of a shift to the side should be enough to get you out of the way of danger and get you in a way where you could be offensive. So we're gonna do a little bit, follow along, and let's get started. Okay, so you gotta stand in your typical JKD stance. And we're gonna do it both ways, conventional and this way. So you gotta look down. So what you gotta do is, when you stepping, okay, they put a stepping, because when you are moving, you don't wanna go like this. Because if you go like this, you're kind of giving away your movement. So you wanna be sneaky about it. So what you gotta do is, you gotta stand on your tippy toes. And when you push, you gotta push with the front leg. And you push back. See, it's a little movement as you go forward. Push. If you go to the side, you push, you push, and you push. Okay, from this side. You hear? Push, 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 push. Okay. If you want to come in an angle, so you gotta go forward and to the right. You gotta go straight. You push. If you want to go to the left, you push to the left, you push back, okay? Now I'm going to show you from a little higher angle. So you're here, so you're going forward, push, push. You want to go forward, you want to go back, push back at an angle. You want to go straight, push, push, back, back. You want to come in an angle, push in an angle. So you're giving little movements. This is a conventional way. In a conventional way. You're here. Here. You want to go this side. You see? So the way it works is like this. I'm here in front of you. If I take just that little shift, you're still here. I put on long for here. Okay. Now, also, upper body movement, in here, here. When you dip, you dip. Don't go forward. You want to have your balance, your weight center. So you drop. 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 So you can go to the turtle shell, you move back. You're here, turtle shell, move back. Step, step. Side, side. And this one. Side, side. On your toes. To the side. And then you shift. You want to get closer to the person. So quick shift with the weight. You want to retreat from the person. Or with a little pivot of your hips. So it's a little something. I hope you liked it. Make sure you like, subscribe, and share. See you soon.